сказал, поехали.
He said, let's go. So let us start. We have now next presenter, Alexander Chistyakov. He will speak about own performance analysis again, gathering and visualization frame graphs. Can you hear me in the microphone? Yes, through the microphone. All right, I work in a DataArt company for the fourth time in my life. I come back to you with the presentation. You're probably champion of the company in the number of presentations. I briefly speak about myself. My position is a senior software developer. I deal with development of different software for the last 18 years, and I also do research at international laboratory in Institute of Fine Mechanics and Optics in St. Petersburg. I also am known as a DevOps engineer, and last 4 years at least I am DevOps engineer, and when people meet me, people want to greet me as a DevOps and probably have questions, but I try to hide because I not really consider myself a DevOps in the full scope because I have other functional interests. I have presentations for you with a lot of bullets. I'll speak about optimization of performance. It's quite simple. As simple as to draw an owl that you see here. The owl, you just draw two circles and then the rest is very easy. So optimization of productivity in Linux is also quite simple. Have you heard the such notion as a comfort zone? Who heard about comfort zone? Everyone knows about that. Who knows? Who was writing once at least a Perl language, using Perl language, then you should know more about comfort zone. What is important is to go sometimes out of the comfort zone to learn some new things. I remember the joke about the comfort zone. What is comfort zone is in business training, business coaching, when a person sitting in California explaining somebody sitting in Magadan that he has to go out of zone of comfort. Which is the whole Magadan is out of comfort. I came out of the zone of comfort tonight, actually. The stars were placed probably in that way that the presentation will be done successfully. And my presentation was not successful before the way I wanted it, but I know how to change it. So that's better. If I knew that, I would just use different template in DataArt. But I unfortunately chose a different template. Tech is a template maker, and so I did it in that template. This presentation, you can easily save your results. I don't like to include much pictures in my slides. I like text more, and I don't like to listen and to watch. You are watching me while I'm speaking. I would rather recommend that you look onto text, and nevertheless, I include quite a lot of bullets, as you see, because I'm not ready to go out that much from the zone of comfort to even reject the bullets that I love very much. Nevertheless, I step out of the zone of comfort and go back. So who of you visited Linux Peter in 2015? If you visited, attended, you probably remember I showed also that slide in that presentation. I stole it from Brendan Gregg. Who knows who Brendan Gregg is? Do you know there is Dima Yemenov in Penza, who is also a Firebird SQL database? They are very similar looking. If you take the face with Gregory, and it's probably Russian Gregory, he's a good engineer. So the good engineer should look like Gordon Gregg. Unfortunately, myself, I don't look like him at all. But this picture looked like this in 2015. A very chaotic picture with a lot of arrows, a lot of squares. It is supposed to be a reflecting Linux system and lots of tools there, and myself on the right of that picture, and normal face, somebody who looks at that. In 2016, Brendan Gregg, 1 month ago actually, he said observable tools reached detrace level as Solaris was in detrace when it was first invented. And fewer arrows now, as you see now on the slide, because if the arrows are too many, too multiple, it is frightening. But notice the picture is still quite cool, and there are a lot of options that you could see in that picture. But notice this is an important stage in observability tools development that the inventor already in detail described in a book even, and he said that in Linux we can do all that in 4.9 kernel, which will happen soon, maybe in the next spring. So soon we'll have kernel 4.9. That is the big step for mankind. But I describe myself here in this slide as a cat behind the person, and they say, okay, you are a cat behind that person. Who is this person shown on the? I have now to narrow my scope of presentation. So I will focus on Linux in this presentation and demo application, because by my age, I'm no longer a hipster, part of a hipster community, a member of that. I still would like to remain a human, and I try to keep updated on web application and other. You can access that website through even any smartphone now. I had a different smartphone. I used to do that. Web application collects different flame graphs and visualizes frame for flame graphs. And what is flame graph, you might ask? Those who attended 2015 conference, you have seen this slide, among others, which explains, shows a flame graph, which I assembled at that time. What is shown here? I try to describe in words to you, and you please try to understand. 1 year ago, we managed that. So flame graph is two-dimensional graph. You have stack call, C stack. One function calls a different function several times, final number of times, because a indefinite number of times would not fit into the picture. So you can take, you can do simplification of that. With certain sequence, you can record those stacks from your processor and store it somewhere in a secular buffer, somewhere in your kernel, as detrace does it, ABP does it now, finally. But never mind, doesn't matter where you store it. The thing is that you collected quite a lot of those, and after equal intervals of time, you see what the program is busy with at your processor. You see good data for profiling of your program. That's statistically reliable information of what is happening, what is executed at the processor most of the time. This raw information you need just to visualize so that it's attractive looking, clear to understand, looking at the picture. You say that we have some common root, and CC is a function called main, and that calls everyone else. And when it calls everyone else, the stacks keep growing in a certain direction. I hope that, as far as I remember, from top to bottom they grow. I was too proud a while ago that I know exactly where a stack grows from and to, from top to bottom. But nevertheless, never mind. We have a common root, and we have a possibility to call the function, and then accumulate those and deposit that along the axis X to represent what is happening in cumulative form on the processor, in milliseconds or tax, but not in that, rather in percentage, how much that function happens takes place in our sample. And y-axis shows the depth of each call. We get, as a result, like rocks from Avatar movie or something. And colors do not mean anything in this picture that you see. They just used to be able to distinguish one bar from the next bar. And also there are function names written. If your program with debug information is assembled, then looking at this name, you can identify what is more often happening on your processor. And ask yourself this question or developer, and why this particular function plays so long on that processor so often. So who of you understands now what is flamegraph? Well, I understand, like last year, some people do keep track of what I'm saying. I think I understand what is flamegraph. Nikolai, who just departed to Moscow, who was presenting before myself, before the person that was before me. And it's difficult, nevertheless, to explain what is flamegraph, although he understands this quite nicely. Flamegraph for 5 years old, a very simplified explanation. So y-axis here shows a depth of calls, one functions is replaced with different. So x-axis shows relative time, in other words, a little bit difficult to understand definitions. I hope you understand. This is not spoken in the microphone. Yes, because they are in line. Yes, they are in line first and then compiled. But maybe we can ask also not to inline that compiler. But it will be looking even more strange. So assembly of flame graphs in 2015 was quite simple. Yeah, picture you remember. There are different methods possible to use to do that assembly. And we want to load processor as little as possible, not overload it. And we sample this in production. Otherwise, it would not be interesting, because in production, different interesting things happen. And we want to know it from production, what is happening, where's the bottleneck or overload. And more than 1,000 requests per second. Who here has that many requests from time to time? There are. Which doesn't matter which request. There are people who have many requests per second. Not even, doesn't matter even how many, but anyway, some requests are handled more often by a professor. And you want to know what it is. You need to do profiling. And the easiest way to take stack frames from production and analyze them. And the easiest way to analyze them is to visualize them. Please show me stack frames for the last 4 minutes. And this is exactly the application that I described to you that does exactly that. Stack frames are collected with certain difficulty normally, because program, besides doing what we try to trace, the processor does also some input-output besides that. And we have to use framework perm events to see what is really happening in the processor. When the program is waiting for input-output and not doing process, and it is difficult to catch, it is possible to catch it, but you should be careful doing that, because in idle status or sleep status, the program can be can find itself more often than during the instances that you sample when it does processing. So my program takes samples of what is happening in the processor. I do not include the periods where the system waits for input output. That is why frame graphs are not that simple. About the zone of comfort, you know, this summer I went, I probably have even the same color. A traveler has to have good boots. So I was not wearing appropriate shoes, and I was complaining about that. I went to a shop and bought myself good trekking boots. I still wear them. They are very comfortable. Rain or mud, doesn't matter. I just feel very comfortable in those boots. This is about zone of comfort. A person who to achieve good results should have good tools, equipment. And we need a good language to write anything for programming purposes, infrastructure code, for example. I opened a page and show it to you now from Wikipedia. This is a list of programming languages. Forefathers. Those are forefathers listed. The languages are even more multiple. A huge, actually, number of languages, and we had to select. How the elections are conducted, we know, looking at this picture. There should be at least two candidates running. There should be a campaign, voting campaign, right? There should be some. Why Lisp? Homo iconicity is your program can operate with data, you can treat your code as data. So the program is written the same type as then abstract syntactic tree would look like. Lisp all homo iconic. And that's why in Lisp it's very easy to do normal macros. Who you see to write code? You did macros too. If you've seen ever macros in C, that is how macros should not be written. That is probably our punishment for our sins, that shoes I used to wear before I bought those new. Macros are used, and then they change the abstract tree and nothing else happens beyond that macros. Nothing is blown. It's like a butterfly effect. When you change something in macros in one place and somewhere else, there is an eruption of a volcano or memory shoots itself, which doesn't normally happen. Optionally, immutability. I am listing properties. They are the characteristic for functional languages of programming, imperative, because I like functional languages of programming, because they allow to make fewer mistakes, avoid mistakes. And if I cannot reassign value for variable, then I do not have that many variables, and I'm less likely to make a mistake. Functions. As a first-class citizen, functions that we can do computation, that's also part of this functional language. That also is included in the Lisp. Second candidate is necessary, as you see. Which language is used currently for infrastructural coding? Golang, right?
Python and others, I don't have to go to GitHub because I know the answer. Why Golang? A quite democratic candidate. Golang, like Hillary Clinton, knows how to deal with those emails. For 9 months, I was writing on Golang. I trusted that language. First, I see what people are writing on it. It's quite cool. It's possible to use, possible to write. Started writing on it, but well, actually, I'm very much disappointed. I dislike many things. It's difficult for me in Ventura. Shall I say why? It gives me the creeps. Why not Golang? Because lots of changes are there. Golang has got the ideas of from 1970s maybe. Really, go long dates back to those ideas of 1970s. 40 years have passed ever since. The languages changed drastically. The languages of originated from RUS, Algol, Korbol, and others, and instead of taking Lisps and using them, those guys have come up with something over sophisticated. And this is out of the 1970s, this Golang thing. And Lisp is different. But it's Golang is not functional enough. As soon as I wrote Lamb in the project, actually the project had ordered me to get rid of that. He doesn't make people to write normal protocols that go long. Like it's like PHP, early Java, trying to get into that niche. Well, you know what I'm talking about. I don't want to be bad to our colleagues, but each one of us have got colleague. We would like to somehow ostracize or just to brand him as the wrongdoer. Golang is for cheap labor force, something like that. I don't want to associate myself with that because I'd been around, I know the score, I've seen it repeatedly, but nonetheless, apart from language, runtime is very important, on which everything will be executed after you launch it. Language should be good or acceptable, and there is also runtime environment and libraries, libs. I think that if we are making an infrastructural thing, there should be very good thing. Golang is the pioneer along those lines. Actually, static linkup is quite good, actually. You can use the binaries in the machine. Good garbage collector is also very important. A decent garbage collector is a must, because some apps can generate a lot of short-lived garbage. You can get rid of it in no time. And actually, the resulting files should not be too big, otherwise it would be a shame. I think that out of all those things, we can select the criteria which would be measurable, because I like numerical things and measurable things. Lisps, okay, I know two Lisps. There are more than that, but major Lisps are only two. I show them. Here it's Logolisp. There is an animated cartoon about that kind of Lisp. So there is a common Lisp and a scheme. I started from common Lisp, 30 megabyte. Its statically linked file after compilation is over 30 megabyte. And I decided that I'm not able to come up with something big with that. 30 megabyte, Golang does around 8 megabyte. Not much. I've got 30 megabyte on the machine, but I want to have more. I would like to have a killer offer, killer application, so I've opted for Schema. Those who were writing Schema, they wanted to teach others to program, and they've come up with several standards. When they were working with the standards, they announced that the design will be minimalistic. It's so over minimalistic, so it's not possible to write anything on it. There are lots of implementations supporting different parts of the standard. There are compilers, transpilers, but everything is so muddled up, quite unclear. I failed. So no boots then. And then it crossed my mind that we can grab everything out of Lisp, but get rid of Lisp itself. That happens sometimes with a language which is called NIM. NIM to the rescue. It used to be called Neymar. Two guys are writing this language there after office hours. After hours, it's very good. Name is great. There is a good book, JavaScript, and pictures about that. The sword is depicted with a very sharp blade and sharp handle by the same token. So I decided that we should write down this Nebus. Strong typing is a must. Without strong typing, we cannot go anywhere. It's JavaScript, it's PHP, and C++. And I see, I also, it's just portable server. C++ is just when Alexander Stepanov was writing his tale. He was running high fever, and he was a mathematician running high fever. He was almost psychedelic, and PHP script is like animated cartoon. It's hilarious. I could show how typing works in those both languages, but you would roll up and roll down with laughter. Typing should be strong by all means, and it should be static, because static typization makes us avoiding many mistakes at the level of the compilation of your binaries. Compiler will check through the compliance with the types. That slightly reduces your ability to write bad code rapidly, but it increases quality. The notorious homo iconicity enables us to implement macro system in a good way. It's all in the name, although name is not Lisp, and it's immutability is also there, and it's possible to disconnect it. It's a fabulous language. And there are algebraic or types of data, and actuarian data, but I'm not well versed in them. And there are templates Golang doesn't have it. Guys are searching high-low for templates. In Java, they're called generics. The founding fathers of Golang say, no way you will not have any templates, period. So, NIM runtime. NIM is compiled into C language. It uses C language as the intermediate representation, which enables you first to make C code and then visit any GCC or CLang platform. As in Erlang, there are two languages. It's per thread, GC. Each thread has got its own garbage collector. That's fabulous. That's the way NIM has it, and Erlang has it. In Java and Golang, it's totally different. You never collect big chunks unless you have identified very high gigabytes of memory in one thread. So statically linked files, it's about slightly more or less 1 megabyte versus 30 megabyte. This is statically linked file having HPC server answering the questions and just not stripped. It's a very good runtime, I think, for language dealt by just by a handful of guys. Now, my project Caldor, it means it has got about 40 commitments at heart. We have to write. The project is called Caldor, which means cold. Why is that? Get outdoors and you'll understand. My colleague has a tradition of using this variant language. I decided to introduce that tradition. This is the repository. You can see here there is the live installation of all that. That's the address. The interface is awful. It's horrendous. and I mean it. I have got some ideas how to improve it, but I'd better outsource this. And there is a to-do list at GitHub, and there is the issues list on GitHub, and I'll have to deal with Git list to enhance the safety to for the binary network from the root. And I don't want to reiterate that. Please don't bring it up to me anymore, because I know how to deal with that. I invite you to join up with that, because actually flame graphs could be seen here in the processor. There's the swiper. It wakes up and thinks that maybe I should get out of this swap. There are two Prometheus containers just going around here. You don't have to pull out anything from the swap, because the machine doesn't have anything else in it. Most part of my flame graph is sort of a sleeping one. Which plans for development do I have? I would like to have not just on CPU and those flame graphs, but also those which are sitting on input-output. I would like to make filtration on flame graphs and to make flame graphs on Python programming language, because actually Peter Pine Spring will happen. We'll have to tell people how to profile projects. And we have got a special pool written in Uber for flame graphs. It needs similar apps to be written, and also we can use it on winter bootstrap, and we can do it bootstrapping, so we'll arrive at very fancy things. No microphone is used from the whole. Well, the ability to write infrastructural things on dynamical typology languages, I strongly doubt it. Python. Well, yes, I heard about it. Static typing in Python. It's meditation, levitation, and maybe a great mourning over something like sobbing over the world in its movement forward consists of small steps. I made a few small steps forward. Join up with me. I'll be developing slowly. I'll be advancing slowly, because if you use thing which is not so sophisticated and developed enough, that would not be gratifying for you. I should enhance those machines and processes first. My conclusions. It's very pleasant and very easy to write presentations and demos in text. Text is great. Before that, for 4 whole years, I was beating about the bush instead of using this wonderful language, despite the fact that actually the command is less than in WinStack. And there is a very small team writing that, but it's a wonderful language. It's rather bizarre concurrency model it has, but I understood everything. It's rather easy. And I guessed the way it should be. So it's a very concise language. Name is great too, and flame graphs are great, and Linux is great, and open source projects are great, and I'm working on all that. Flame graphs, well, they are cool, like I said, because they are concise and visualizing everything which goes on to profile in a very good way, which happens before your very eyes, especially if your application is written on C++, it is language, let's say everything is compiled with the back symbols. Mailer distributors have got these back symbols ability, so you can sort out what exactly your processor is doing. At least I can, and I call upon you. You should figure it out as well. And I told you Linux is great. Linux, nothing but Linux. Linux, Peter, yes. Windows, Peter, have you seen anything like that? Or Solaris, Peter, for that matter? No, it's Linux, Peter. IX, Peter, yes. Linux, Peter. Open source. It's good enable something, but actually, I work a lot in GitHub. You may join up with me. I try to join up with others to get connected, but they want me to sign CLAs with them. They're bureaucrats, them lousy bureaucrats. I don't need anything from you. Okay, guys, just take it from me. And actually, later on, if you are going to copyright your own code like that, you'll surprise me no end. And I'll have to rewrite the same thing, and then we'll go different ways. You'll go right, I'll go left. Questions, please. Well, I might ask myself questions, but it's better if you ask me questions. No microphone is used. Questions? Could you show us your system, the way it looks like? Let's try, I need a PC with computer. If it's a notebook with internet, I'll try to show you. It looks like the web site look like, well, the demo is not yet ready. And I tell you that about 10 minutes from now, we'll finally an official close of the conference. So hang on. Do we have internet here? Well, it's not the wonderful operational system, maybe. I don't know how to just connect it. Maybe there is an adapter someplace here. In point of fact, maybe it is. There are so many flame graphs there. So I'm afraid that there will be something like a short circuit. Because it went on working like that for several days, and it's about 2600 daily. That's a lot. First of all, thank you very much. Indeed, everything is cool. I am trying different languages as well. Now, about 3 days ago, I tried Dart. Well, yes, we're doing the same thing, you and me. Open source, that's cool. Could you show code on NIM? Of course. Who was writing on Turbo Pascal? Well, I'm going to show you. You'll see familiar ones. On Turbo Pascal, actually, I don't like to write on Turbo Pascal. I like to write on NIM, but not on NIM, but not on Turbo Pascal. That's it. Well, that's the code on NIM. It's such a Pascal, which is Python. Yes, you're right, yes. That's where immutability is exactly. That's what I'm showing you now.
Very good language. At least the authors have to optimize it. They have a collection of finances for that, at least $10. When they accumulate, they would probably optimize that. This is not a gauche topic. This everything is okay. There was acceptance. There is everything there. There is a very good picture where this gauche mascot shown, and a human comes to and says, "Oh, so cute." a piece of MR code in a cloud that is shown in the. He says, no, no, it's retarded. Okay, yes, Maxine, you can. Well, you need to pay. You don't need to pay. You're grown up. This is not spoken into the microphone. Yes, yes, correct. You can write what it should be throwing out. There are programs. That is eclectic, very eclectic language. There are actually four languages inside, mixed up, and specification and exclusions. Shell acceptance is as in Java. It is there, yes. It is nice to write in. Different people find it convenient. Everything you need, I don't know why the net is down. We'll have to clarify that. Well, there is echo, right? There is echo. I didn't know that there is echo. That's why I used something else instead. I don't see that. I probably deleted it. In other commits, preceding commits, I can check. List of commits. Here. Unfortunately, demonstration doesn't work. The interface is of 1996, quite old. Yeah, you see, that is what I did. Write into a CDR so that it will work. Put a trace, I have a question. 4.9 will have support of detrace, a full analog. A detracer, yes. 4.9 would add time sampling. Folding of stack traces would be possible to do just inside MPPM. Full support, the same language. No, no, not the same language. Language is copyrighted. The language should be different, and it is currently being written, being developed. Complete set has been prepared, but inside everything is different. Language is more complex. A virtual machine is there. It executes the code, but the language is completely different. From you, we can hear an opinion. Why Haskin and Ryles didn't run for president? Well, I know a friend who writes in Haskell, and I was selecting language. He said to me, no matter which language you will choose, you would write in Haskell anyway. I remember this, and I think that I will always find time to study Haskell. You know, you always want to play around before you marry. It's the same here. The same friend told me something like this. I know, I looked at that language, and I'm too silly for that. And if he is too silly for that language, I'm even more silly for that language, not for me. I need to play around before I marry. But there are more experienced people here who can answer this. Okay, if there are no questions anymore, then we thank the speaker. I have a channel in Telegram. You can subscribe. This is now fashionable.